Its name was Tyrannosaurus Rex. It was 13 meters long and weighed 6 tons. This awesomely powerful creature was king of the dinosaurs. Much about T-Rex has been shrouded in mystery. Now, with modern technology, a clear picture is taking shape. Remarkable physical capabilities that defy conventional wisdom. An advanced brain and intellect for hunting.
We look at their brain and wonder whether that enlarged cerebrum may have actually had the capacity to be involved in sort of a coordinated group hunting effort.
In addition, new fossil finds from around the world are revealing the origins of this enormous predator. It turns out that T-Rex's ancestors were actually small and frail.
They were something much smaller, much weaker.
Somehow, tyrannosaurs transformed from small creatures threatened by their enemies into the most powerful dinosaurs of them all. Starting with the very earliest ancestors, we'll explore an amazing tale of evolution. Siblings on a journey in search of new lands. They cross paths with a fearsome carnivore. Which will reign supreme? The King of Kings, Tyrannosaurus Rex. This is a story of 100 million years of remarkable evolution. Inside a 160 million year old soil strata, they found a completely new meat-eating dinosaur. A crown-like appendage on its head inspired its name, Guanlong, or crown lizard. Xu and his team conducted a detailed analysis of the teeth and bones. They determined that Guanlong was T-Rex's ancestor. Ah, there they are. A group of Guanlong siblings. They're on the hunt. One takes off. Perhaps he's the oldest. He closes in on his prey. But he's no match. At this point in time, the Guanlong was just 3 meters, dwarfed by the 13-meter-long T-Rex. It weighed only 75 kilograms, 1/80th of the weight of its massive cousin.
The very oldest Tyrannosaurs were much, much different, much smaller, but they didn't have anywhere near the firepower of a T-Rex. They were kind of like, cats or dogs, kind of that type of animal. They weren't, the big bears or the big lions or the big tigers at the top of the food chain.
How did such a small and relatively weak creature eventually lead to T-Rex? The largest dinosaur of them all.
The story of Tyrannosaurs is really a story about evolution. And one of the things that it tells us is that evolution is unpredictable. When those very first Tyrannosaurs like Guanlong entered the scene 170 million years ago, you never would have thought that they would ultimately evolve into giant, monstrous animals like T-Rex, but that's what happened. How were they able to survive for so long, for 80 million years, as these small, human-sized carnivores? And then maybe the biggest mystery of all, how were those small Tyrannosaurs able to switch and become these giant, dominant super predators?
The keys to unlocking these mysteries are newly discovered fossils from around the world, Researchers have discovered 28 species related to T. rex. Brusatti has conducted detailed analyses of the bones of some of these specimens. His goal was to clarify the process behind T. rex's evolution. The approach he used is called phylogenetic analysis.
We have hundreds and hundreds of those features that vary in these dinosaurs. Some have the bones, some don't. Some have small muscle attachments, some have big ones. Some have triangle-shaped bones or projections, others have square-shaped ones. Those kind of features that are variable.
Brusatti's analyses have illuminated 366 distinctive characteristics of tyrannosaur bones. And the data he's amassed form the basis for mapping T. rex's family tree. The results confirm that the diminutive Guanlong was indeed the most primitive species of tyrannosaur. From the time the first Guanlong emerged until T. rex appeared took 100 million years. Over this time, dramatic evolutionary advances created a creature of unparalleled dominance.
So it is an unusual animal, a freak of nature, a feat of evolution. And I'm fascinated to learn, to try to understand how evolution makes an animal like T. rex. That's the mystery that drives me in the research that I do.
160 million years ago, China's Jianggao Basin was home to the Guanlong. This species then migrated to North America. And about 70 million years ago, T. rex appeared. The question is why T. rex's ancestors left their familiar environment and set out on their epic journey. A clue can be found in the southern reaches of the Pacific Ocean. 5,000 meters beneath the surface lies an enormous lava plateau. Naohiko Okochi has studied the formation.
その size がですね、とてつもなく大きくて、北海道から沖縄までがすっぽり入ってしまうほどの大きさですね。だいたい2000キロメーター四方と。
This huge lava mass was created by a major geological event 120 million years ago. Deep inside the Earth is a swirling mass of matter called the mantle. Magma suddenly surged up, erupting through fissures in the ocean floor. The Pacific Ocean wasn't the only place this occurred. All over the world, volcanoes violently burst to life. These major eruptions also occurred on the Eurasian continent, where the primitive tyrannosaurs lived. They had no choice but to flee. Leaving familiar territory behind, they began a journey into the unknown. They headed toward the north for a reason. Climate change. The gases released by volcanic eruptions contained large amounts of carbon dioxide. This triggered global warming.
二酸化炭素の濃度が現在の、およそ 2.5 倍から5倍それによって温室効果が起きまして植生をですね大きく、北極圏へまで広げそしてそれが最終的には恐竜のですね、生態を変えてあるいは進化を引き起こしたというふうに考えても不思議ではないと思います。
As the earth warmed, lush forests sprouted up from Siberia to the Arctic. Xu Xing believes this greening of the north encouraged the Tyrannosaurus migration. Into the unknown. Searching for a new home with bountiful game, they start out on their epic journey. They arrive on the eastern edge of the Eurasian continent. In front of them is a vast ocean. And just when it seems they can't go any further, something incredible happens.